Will the BJJ multiple world champion be able to successfully turn her hand to mixed martial arts on one of the biggest stages there is here at the Singapore Indoor Stadium?
Mona Samir coming out in the wrestling singlet, so you gotta wonder. We saw her in one of her previous fights against Angela Lee show some really good takedowns as she took down the current champion. But, you know, is she gonna employ such a strategy against the eight-time Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu champion? A
couple of good right hands from Michelle Nicolini landing, but now she gets to grips with her opponent, and this is where she lives. And it could be over very quickly, although she slipped out of that rear naked choke attempt. What else is going on there, Mitch?
Yeah, Mona Samir needs to run for her life right now. Having a third-degree black belt, the capability of Nicolini on your back, it's only a moment in time before that rear naked choke comes in. But she's got so many different transitions from here. Right now, Mona Samir's doing the right thing. She's fighting that hand, but she's got to create some scrambles. But look how tightly Nicolini has her legs wrapped around Samir.
Her left arm is pretty much tied up by Mona Samir at the moment. She may be overemployed, though, looking after that.
Yeah, she's got to create some movement here, Steve. She's got to start transitioning. And she's trying to roll out of it, but Michelle Nicolini is not going to give this up. And I think that hand is starting to slip underneath. Nicolini specializes in footlocks, triangles. She can finish the fight from so many different angles. And there it is, trying to slide that arm underneath the chin. But Mona Samir's doing the right thing. She's lasted this long with her on the back.
What can she do from here, Samir? Obviously defend the rear naked choke, but how can she,
well, that's what she's got to try to do. She's got to try to spin and face Nicolini here. She can't let herself get flattened out like that. That's the wrong thing that she wants to do, but she's got to try to turn. You see how Michelle Nicolini's got that, the left hand there? Oh, now she's got the right hand.
Now so it's underneath. It's underneath the chin now. Uh-oh. This cannot go on much longer. She's tapped out, and we've got a first round win on a one championship debut from the eight-time Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu world champion.
Time, ready? Ready?
High-level athletes here coming together right now in Manila.
No surprise of either one of these two games plans. Mazepa wants to keep it on the feet. Nicolini wants it on the ground. Other than our world title fight, I don't think there's a more anticipated fight on the entire card than what you're witnessing right now.
As soon as this one was announced, I've been looking forward to it. Every fight starts on the feet, and that is where Mazepa's clear advantage is. But once they get into close quarters, that's the world owned by Nicolini, and there we are.
That's what I was looking for. I was waiting for Mazepa to throw that leg kick to see if Nicolini would snatch it up and take her to the ground, and that's exactly what happened.
And what does Mazepa have on the deck defensively?
Well, now you can see Nicolini's trying to pin down her left arm there, but, you know, Mazepa's got to start moving. But Nicolini's already sliding that knee on belly. She's probably going to look for a mount, but, you know, Mazepa can't hold on like that. She's got to start pushing her away to create some scrambles so she can get moving.
So she's pulling that right arm in. You're saying that's the wrong thing to do?
Yeah, she doesn't want to pull her close to her. She wants to push her away and start moving her hips to the other side so she can create some distance and start moving. Now Nicolini's going knee on belly, slides right into mount effortlessly. And now she's just picking apart, softening her up. So you can see she's holding on to Nicolini, and that just holds her in that position. She has to push her away, but it's a completely different world when you have a third degree black belt on top of you. Here comes the arm bar. You can see her setting it up, transition, but pure muscle from Mazepa to bridge out of that. Now she needs to run. Now she needs to get moving, push away and run.
She is a very strong woman, Mazepa.
She does not want to stay in the garden. No, Nicolini, up she goes. No, Nicolini's easily. Here comes that arm bar.
Arm's in trouble.
Here's
now.
The arm. She's better. She's going to tap her. She's going to take it home.
She's tapping, and it was over quickly. And the winner is Michelle Nicolini, the BJJ specialist.
Two. How long before this one between two grapplers goes to ground? Big open.
Takedown from Nicolini. Very easily ducked under that huge grab right hand, slides over, easily passes the guard, almost zero resistance, has the knee on belly. Kisilova's got to start pushing away. She can't just hold her there, but she's able to possibly get back into half guard. And Michelle Nicolini just kind of pushes it off.
What does Kisilova do with a human octopus on top of her? This is Nicolini's world. This is Nicoliniville. Any amount of options available for the eight-time BJJ world champion. And she drops some elbows, a little bit of ground and pound, softening up the Ukrainian. Another slicing elbow.
She might be looking for that arm, or a head and arm triangle. The head and arm triangle is not really there, but she's trying to pass the guard here. She's going to slide that knee right through. Kisilova's in a bad state. There's an arm triangle. She just pops her arm out. It might be there.
Nicolini says she wants a chance at one championship gold. She wants to send a message tonight. And she says the victim has to be Irina Kisilova.
Let's see Kisilova just holding on to that head for dear life. Now Nicolini's looking to take the back. She might step over. Yep, just like that. Now she's going to flatten Kisilova out. Kisilova's got to let go of that head. That's not... All it's going to do is allow time for Nicolini to settle. She's going to push those hands off of her head. Now she's in the full mount position. She uses the knee very wisely to break the grip of Kisilova.
Dropping elbows, dropping fists down on Kisilova as Michelle Nicolini from the full mount, the Brazilian. Not where you want to be. Fully mounted by Michelle Nicolini.
Kisilova's just...
Oh, she gives it back to Nicolini. This could be a cardinal mistake.
The headlock is her only defense, and easily Nicolini shrugs that off. That's like what they teach you in your first day of BJJ is how to defend the headlock.
Oh, Nicolini, can she put the hooks in and flatten out the very long body of Kisilova? She can. Here it comes. Nicolini with the choke. Lydia Kost right on top of the action. Is Kisilova going to give up? She may be unconscious.
Beautifully done. And that was just a BJJ clinic.
Single leg takedown early on from Nicolini. You know she wants to get Angela down. She gets her down again.
She's got that body lock and she lands in side control. Angela's got to start moving those hips out to the side. Let's see if she can regain guard. You can see just how tight Michelle Nicolini's leg is to the body of Angela Lee. So Angela Lee's gonna try to hip escape out and try to get her left leg inside the guard of Michelle Nicolini. But Michelle Nicolini is so tough on the ground. And these two have grappled before. In 2016, they grappled in a grappling contest. And now Michelle Nicolini is in full mount. And Michelle Nicolini walked away with a victory in like 3 minutes via toe hold.
This is exactly where Nicolini wants to be.
Oh, big bridge by Angela Lee. And the top
is exactly what Angela Lee wants to do. What an amazing opening minute here. Angela Lee inside the guard of Michelle Nicolini. Can Lee posture up? Break open that close guard now. She's trying to.
Look at Michelle Nicolini. She's trying to trap that arm. See how she's trying to pin down the right arm here of Angela Lee. Let's see if she throws her hips up and attacks an arm bar. You can see immediately she puts her foot on the hip. She's trying to create an angle. Now she's threatening a triangle. She's close. Angela's got to keep that foot away from sliding over the top of her arm. Oh, it's going over. Angela's got to be very careful. The triangle is momentarily, just moments away from being cinched up. That shoulder is the only thing preventing Michelle Nicolini from locking that triangle up. Now she's one step closer. Good job by Angela Lee to avoid that triangle.
Angela Lee defends. Close guard here from Nicolini. An amazing opening 2 minutes this way. So many pundits were divided on this contest. Second time at strawweight for Angela Lee. First time out, March 31 in Tokyo, lost to Zhong Jinnan, the world champion. Lee is still the atomweight world champion. And here she is at strawweight for a second time.
Beautiful way she makes those hips. This is high-level Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, ladies and gentlemen. Look at the way she's trapped those arms. Hard for Angela Lee to go anywhere. She's trying to butterfly, elevate on the legs. Good job by Angela Lee to avoid that. See the sweep coming. She's trying to elevate her sweeper. She's trying to put her feet on the hips and trying to create a little bit of elevation on Angela Lee. Maybe catching her falling into something, possibly an armbar or a triangle. Angelique's doing a good job of defending so far. This is an 8-time BJJ world champion, third degree Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt on the bottom right now.
Nicolini 5-2, 5 submission wins, also 4-time no-gi grappling world champion. Has first round wins over the likes of Irina Kisilova, who she subbed with a rear naked choke, an armbar of Irina Mazepa, and a rear naked choke of Mona Samir. On the feet is where Nicolini usually comes undone.
Oh, look at the way she's got that hand trapped. Now she's gonna try to slide that foot in, possibly looking for another armbar here. Might be going for a triangle.
Both women coming off a loss. Nicolini lost to Tiffany Teo last time out in November. Teo really did own her in the stand-up. And this is where Nicolini wants to keep this contest on the ground. That's not a secret, never has been.
Angelique's doing a good job of defending so far. Shut down all the attacks of Michelle Nicolini right now.
Angela Lee, 9-1, 6 submissions, 1 knockout win.
1 minute left in the first round.
First round victories, the first 3 matches in their pro career, all ended in the very first round. Aya Sayed Sabre, Mona Samir, and Natalie Gonzalez-Hill. All 3 by submission, a twister, a rear naked choke, and an armbar.
Angelique's got to be very careful. She's got to either keep both hands inside the legs of Michelle Nicolini or both hands outside the legs. She can't allow Michelle Nicolini to push one of her arms through her legs. You can see the way she keeps trying to overhook those arms and try to lock one arm into position. Angelique's doing a beautiful job at defending so far.
15 seconds remains in what has been an enthralling opening round. Close guard from Nicolini, opens it up now to Brazilian.
10 seconds.
It again.
Watch her back of the head. Watch her back of the head, watch out.
Defense from the Atomweight Queen. Let's see what Michelle Nicolini can do here in the last couple seconds. Not a whole lot.
And we will start, of course, the next round in a stand-up position. 1 down and 2 remaining.
So we saw it, Michelle Nicolini was able to get into mount. That's a bad spot, but look at that bridge. Look at Angela Lee just going oopa and bridging over the top, putting Michelle Nicolini on her back. Michelle Nicolini was very close to a couple of triangles there. Very, very close, but stellar defense from Angela Lee. She was able to stop any offense coming from Michelle Nicolini. Now, we've gotten that out of the way. That's going to be a huge confidence boost for Angelique going into the second round. Now let's see how the game plans kind of adjust and how does Michelle Nicolini attack this second round.
3 judges here ringside are scoring on an overall contest, not round by round.
All right, ready?
Inside the Sandown Axiata Arena in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. It's 1 championship, Masters of Destiny.
This is a really important match for Angela Lee. As we all know, she's got another title tilt coming up in Japan. Michelle Nicolini's diving for the single leg. Oh, she pulls guard. Risky move here for Angela Lee. Attack the leg now. Oh, good job, Angela Lee, to get the leg out.
Nicolini wants Angela to stay on the ground with her.
Oh, look at that. She was able to use the threat of the heel hook to actually sweep her over and end up on top now. This is where Michelle Nicolini is going to try to get. She's going to try to cut through the guard. Those legs that Angela Lee has in front of Michelle Nicolini are preventing her from attacking. So now Michelle Nicolini needs to get past those legs, and she's going to try to do that by taking that knee and sliding right through. That foot, the only thing stopping her right now. Oh, she steps over to the other side. Good job by Angela Lee to maintain butterfly guard.
1 minute down already. First round was intriguing. I got some brilliant world-class BJJ in the MMA ring. And it's happening again here, Mitch.
Good job by Angela Lee to maintain that guard. This is a third-degree black belt, 8-time Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu world champion on top of you, trying to get through your guard. Angela Lee's doing a good job. Like, so you're trying to get that underhook on the right side, working way back up to her feet. She's trying to bridge again, might get over back in the process. Nicolini's moments away from getting mount. There's full mount. Look how Nicolini's on top now with the guard. She's gonna try to get that knee past her guard, and she's gonna try to cut right through that guard. See how she's positioning that foot? She's trying to end up in mount. See how she could just slide right through and go to half guard, but she's trying to get back to her knee onto the other side of the body. See, right here, she could just slide right through and end up in side control, but she doesn't want that. She wants to go full on to mount, I think.
250 remains, second round of three. Michelle Nicolini, top position. Okay, Mitch, I want you to play coach for a moment here, Dragon. If you're in the corner of Nicolini, what are you telling her to do right now?
Yeah, exactly what I'm telling her to do. Get into side control, control that position, bring up the mount, step over that way. Now she's in full mount. She's trying to do the bumps again. She's trying to create those hip bridges, but Michelle Nicolini's got that figured out. See how she kind of lets her ride now? She's not staying hip to hip with her. So if Angela Lee's able to bridge, Michelle Nicolini is kind of giving her a little bit of space to create that bridge so she can stay up on top. Beautiful adjustment there by Nicolini.
Nicolini, the most well-credentialed ground stylist that Angela Lee has ever faced. And here she is in full mount of the world atomweight champion, Nicolini. It's a ground and pound. Angela tries to throw the legs up.
She's trying to scrap the back door, wrapping those legs around, but you can see the way Nicolini's starting to move those legs up nice and high. See, she's figured out the bump here. Angela's trying to do it, but see how high she is? How she's got her knees up near the armpits of Nicolini. It's very tough, of Angela Lee. It's very tough for Angela Lee to bridge now because her hips, she's not hip to hip, she just can't get the momentum.
1 minute 20 remains. Michelle Nicolini, long time in full mount of Angela Lee. What you looking for here, Dragon?
She's trying to go knee on belly. I think she's trying to create a little bit of posture, drop some ground and pound. That arm's trapped. There might be an arm bar here. To stop any sort of offense coming from the mount from Nicolini. Nicolini was in mount twice there. I think she was in mount for about 90 seconds there, and she wasn't able to do anything. Angelique did a great job of reversing the position. Now she's in the guard of Nicolini. Nicolini's got 30 seconds to work here. She's got to do some work.
Just controlling Angela's posture. Doesn't want that ground and pound raining down on her. Under 20 seconds to go now. Second round of three, it's been a thriller. It looks like we're gonna go into the third round. There's a lot of people who did not expect it to get this far. And indeed, we are going in to the deep water. Where are you watching live in over 140 countries around the world? We hope you're enjoying the best martial arts action on the planet. It's one championship from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia.
See, that's a... Michelle Nicolini was having a lot of success with the ground and pound there in side control, but she wanted mount. Look at that, the way she... Angelique tried to bridge, Michelle Nicolini like rode her like a surfer riding a wave, waited for that, and then was able to get on top. But then Angela Lee digs deep within herself and forces herself up on top to sit there in the guard of Nicolini. And Michelle, Angela Lee was able to do good work on top, but not enough. It's very close, and man, there's been like, what, four punches thrown the entire time?
Third and final round between two world champions who know each other so well. Former teammates at Evolve MMA. And they competed against each other, of course, in Macau in a grappling contest. In Macau, not many moons ago, it was Nicolini who emerged triumphant. That's been a lot of the talk in the lead up to this one. Does Nicolini have a psychological advantage over Angela Lee, having beaten her in a grappling contest in Macau years ago?
Quite possibly, but we see right now that beautiful spot. Michelle Nicolini's trying to get that takedown. She's trying to get that body lock. You can see how she's hanging, trying to pull guard right here. Good job by Angelica Sprawl and up in side control. Watch that right leg. Reverse the position. She started her career at strawweight, so the first time she went up against Zhang Jingna, that was not her first trip to strawweight, so she's been here before.
The popping left hand there from Angela Lee, top position for Lee. Third and final round here.
Oh, look at that reversal from Michelle Nicolini. Possible, it looks like she's trying to attempt an arm bar here, but Nicolini's able to work her way around side control now. Neon belly, looks like she's trying to go for it again. Got that leg cradled nice and tight.
Michelle Nicolini, so many options available to the 8-time world BJJ champion, 4-time no-gi grappling world champion, BJJ third degree black belt. Mitch, are you surprised that Angela could not keep it on the feet, or didn't keep it on the feet for a lot longer tonight? Because most people expected it to be Angela's striking prowess and Nicolini's ground game.
You know, I gotta say, I am a little surprised, but I'm not surprised at what Michelle Nicolini is able to do here because of what she's been working on, the way that she's been working on these things, and who she's been working with specifically. She's at a school that is designed around grapplers and how grapplers can utilize wrestling and striking to manipulate. And that's what she's doing right here. She is allowing Angela Lee into her game, but Angela Lee's able to get that shot. Adjustments, all these sweeps, just beautifully done by Nicolini. Full guard now, it looks like, possibly full guard, looks like she might be in half guard, actually. Nicolini's trying to step over into mount, side control might get the back here. Usually he's doing a good job, though, of trying to maintain this position.
1 minute, 35 remains here, Dragon. What's Nicolini going for?
Big bridge, she's just trying to get in the mount. That arm's nice and high there, she could possibly trap that arm. There's Nicolini. A lot of back and forth action here, this one's gonna be tough. But it's obviously Michelle Nicolini who's on top, she's possibly threatening. Another triangle here. Let's see if Angela Lee can defend again.
Keeps the head out, Angela Lee.
1 minute left in the final round.
Disrupt the balance of Angela Lee now.
Close guard from Nicolini, under a minute remaining. Elbow off the back there.
That's
from
what
Nicolini.
Angela needs a lot of ground and pound. But look how Michelle's wrapping up the arms with the overhooks, shutting down all the ground and pound coming from her.
Oh, the chance for Angela.
Nicolini's arms are kind of defending there on Angela's left hand. Wow, what a match.
Incredible!
What a match.
Absolutely incredible. Two amazing warriors. And whatever bad blood there may have been between them has now been squashed. Two amazing athletes. Two amazing martial arts world champions who gave it their all.
And look at here, Angela Lee was able to get up on top, but look at the way Michelle Nicolini's able to utilize her leg to disrupt the balance and get that foot on the inside, sweep Angela Lee over. It was an absolute beautiful ground performance from Michelle Nicolini. She was just one step ahead of the Atomweight Queen in almost every single one of those exchanges. Just a beautiful Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu performance put on by the eight-time Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu World Champion, Michelle Nicolini.
Amazing contest, a back and forth battle. Let's go now to Tom Lau for our decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner, Michelle Nicolini.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.